Hi, it's Brian from iSpring, and today we're going to find out how to create a customer support scenario in PowerPoint. Thanks to the iSpring Content Library, you can find complete templates to build a course in minutes. One of the brand new templates is a technical support training dialog. Let's close out of here and see how to fine-tune it to your specifications. Just like any slide templates, you'll need to replace the text with your specific information. Give it a title and description, and change the completion time if needed. Continue to enter custom text on all the following slides. If you like, you can change the characters and backgrounds as well. Here in the character library, it's easy to find the character and pose you're looking for. We'll want business attire, and you can also choose gender, age, and ethnicity. The most important parameters, of course, are the actions. You can even type the word phone in the search field to get characters talking on the phone. Choose the right direction and emotion, and you've got the perfect character photo for any situation. Once your character is inserted on the slide, it works just like any other PowerPoint object, and you can delete the other character. Now let's see how to make the dialogue interactive. Down here on slide 9, we have some answer choices. To make them clickable, right-click and choose Hyperlink, then link it to whichever slide is appropriate. For example, you may give the learner a warning that this might not be the right thing to say. Let's press Shift F5 on the keyboard and do a little preview. Works perfectly! Now let's scroll back up here to slide 13 and see how to attach audio. Go to the Insert tab and choose Audio. Then drag this annoying object off to the side where it won't be seen. Then you can go to the Playback tab and make it start automatically, or you can go to the Animations tab and set up a trigger on click of the Playback button. How did I find the Playback button? Go to the Home tab, open the Selection pane, and there's our guy. As you can see, I've already renamed it to something identifiable. Okay, now you might notice there are some buttons, like up here on slide 11 and 12, so you'll want to go to Insert, click Action, and make it a hyperlink to the next slide, for example. Just make sure you put all the slides in the right order to maintain the logic of the scenario. Finally, let's go to the last slide and link this button back to the beginning of the scenario. We'll just right-click, go to Hyperlink, and select the first slide. Again, we'll press Shift F5 to see how it looks. Looks great! Just make sure you go through your whole scenario and make sure all these buttons and links work. Then, when you publish with iSpring Suite, everything will work just like it does in PowerPoint. Thanks for watching! Now you know how to create a customer support scenario in PowerPoint. Don't forget, you can get this template and much more assets from the iSpring Content Library. Find out more right now at iSpringSolutions.com. Did you like this video? Give it a like and subscribe to the iSpring YouTube channel for more updates.